Coach, coming off of a couple of dual meet victories tonight against Limestone and Lander, respectively, your thoughts on how your team wrestled tonight?
I'm going to hold how we wrestle for later on, but I am so proud of my guys. You know, the way they've carried themselves over the last 5 months, you know, is next to nothing, you know, as far as the sacrifices they've made for each other, for themselves, you know, for us to have the opportunity to, you know, do something that we've never done in a long time. I don't know if it's ever been done in the school history, but just for these guys to weather the storm over these last 5 months, you know, the wins tonight were great, but it's gratifying to know that these guys are willing to put themselves in the back burner for the good of the team. And that makes me super proud to be the leader of this organization and to be, you know, going to battle with these guys every day. And I think it says a lot about these young men and the people they're going to become in the future.
When you look at tonight was senior night, when you look at these three seniors, what do they mean to this program?
You know, I think a lot of time in sports, people only look at the guys on the court, on the mat, on the field, the pitch. You know, guys like Matt Engel is a workhorse. You know, the guy shows up to work every day with his pail, ready to go with whoever he's asked to go with. You know, trying to get his teammates better, and he never says no when you tell him he got to make weight an hour before. He's ready to go. You know, that guy right there, again, he's going to be a great employee. He's going to be a great husband and a great dad in the future because he has the work ethic. You know, you think about a guy like Ethan Hanasco, you know, who I've known for a very long time. You know, he wrestled for my high school coach, and you just knew Ethan had it in him. You know, another guy that's going to be going to do some great things, you know, going to the healthcare field. And Ethan is just, you know, been a workhorse for our program as well. And a guy that, again, he was ready when he was called on. And just to have those guys in our program and just to see them mature as young men into adults, it's just gratifying to know that, you know, we were a part of their development. And it's, you know, it's a pleasure for the parents to trust us with their development and just to watch how they've grown into men. You know, obviously, you know, you got Luke McDonough here. I remember trying to seal the deal, driving up to New York to watch him in a tournament. You know, and I knew he had it. You know, we knew he had it in him, and we had to go up there to seal the deal. You know, coming from South and making sure those Northern schools don't, you know, just see him and pay attention to him. So I think going up there and just sealing the deal was huge for us. You know, Luke's had a very, very tough time, but again, another opportunity, another way of a guy persevering through some tough times. You know, not just wrestling, but off the mat, and just being able to just show up every day, do his best. And just know that, you know, we're there for them. And it's not always clean, but, you know, we try to make sure these guys, you know, they're not going through these tough times by themselves. And to see him perform like the way he performed tonight, just to see him put it all together, be consistent, it's great to see. Obviously, those three guys mean a lot to our program, and they can be replaced. No matter who we bring in, those guys can be replaced, and we're super grateful to be a part of their development as young men. We're excited for, obviously, those other two guys, but we're excited to see where Luke goes here over the next couple of weeks getting ready for regionals.
Yep, Luke, you still have a couple more weeks to wrestle, you and your team, but when you look back at your time at UNC Pembroke, what comes to mind?
Honestly, it's, you know, something kind of simple, just a team, you know? Like, this past couple of weeks, I've been really thinking, like, you know, my time's coming to an end. Like, have I gotten out of this? And I, on top of getting better at the sport, I'd say I create a lot of friendships on this team. Like my buddy Javon right there, like we're tight, you know, my son. You know, it's like, no, I'm just kidding. Nah, but I have a bunch of, I'm cool with everybody on the team. Like they're all my brothers, and that's something that's going to be hard to leave, honestly, by the end of the year.
What was this overall experience like tonight for you on your senior night?
It was awesome. Like, there's only one word to put it. It was awesome. You know, it felt good. You know, some things didn't go my way tonight, but, like, you know, I just dug deep in, just pulled it out somehow, you know, just tried to get that win for the team.
That first bout, I know it got a little bit chippy, but you're able to keep a level head. How were you able to come away with that victory?
I just, you know, I wanted to break them, like, because I know we know Limestone as a team. Like, the condition is, and are as good as ours, and I just wanted to break them. And, like, I don't care what the score was. I knew by the end of the match I would be on top because I know Kid will start breaking as I keep putting the pressure on him.
Javon, big night for you as well. What was working for you out there today?
You know, just heavy hand fighting, staying in a good stance, trusting my training. That's the biggest thing. We practice staying in our stance a lot. So, you know, heavy hand fight, staying on my stance, keeping good position. I know I can get those wins, those tough, gritty matches, and come out on top.
OT talked a bit about what the senior class means to him and this program. What do these three seniors mean to you?
Those are my brothers. I'm definitely going to miss them. Luke, Engle, Ethan. Like, I used to live with Ethan, so that's like Luke and Ethan, my son. But I'm definitely going to – I'm ready to see them do great things. I know Matt Engle, he's going into the military. You know, me being in the military, I know he'll do big things, being in leadership position, because he is a leader, unsung hero on this team that doesn't get enough credit. So I just want people to know, like, even though you might not see him, he is a big part of this program. And he does push his middle weights, upper weights. Like Coach said, whenever we need him, he's ready to go. So, yeah, we're definitely going to miss him a lot.
Coach, how does tonight prepare you guys for the next step in the Super Regional?
I think a lot of times when opportunities like this present themselves, you know, a lot of coaches are going to just praise their team. I definitely want to praise our opponents. You know, those guys could have easily opted out and gave an excuse, but both coaches prepared the team to come in here and wrestle us, especially during these tough times. It's something that is not going to go unnoticed on us, and we're grateful for the opportunity. And I think that put us where we need to be. Now our staff and our guys all have more film they can go and look at and get us prepared. We don't have everything we need right now, but we're going to get there. We're going to get these 2 weeks to rest, you know, heal up, and put an edge in our conditioning and get ready to make some adjustments to, you know, bring back another regional championship to UNC Pembroke.
Guys, congrats on the win tonight. Best of luck in a couple of weeks to Super Regionals.
Thank you. I definitely want to thank a few people, obviously. John, your staff, man, you guys do an awesome job. I'm super excited to, you know, continue to have you guys have us back here in a couple of weeks when we host another regional tournament trophy. You know, you guys do a great job covering our program, you know, making sure our guys get the attention they need. You know, definitely want to thank all you guys, Todd and everyone. You know, obviously, definitely want to thank Joey Tambera for putting everything in place for our athletes to be able to compete. You know, the tests, I know they've been crazy, and we've been having some time just trying to navigate this. But, you know, Joey and his staff have done a great job. Our athletic department, man, you can't say nothing but great things about the way our institution has really put us in a position to have this opportunity for these young men, for these seniors, to just be able to put the shoes on for one last time, for one last season. Obviously, Lauren, our trainer, she's been on our ass every single time we don't do our job just to make sure we're here to get to this point, and she's going to continue to do it, and we're super grateful for that. You know, my staff, Tyler, you know, Juan, Derek, Andrew, you know, the team. These guys are freaking awesome, man. People need to support kids. People need to support kids. Kids are going through a lot right now, and people need to support them. You know, they're sacrificing a lot, and people need to make sure they support them. You guys, people need to support what you guys are doing, because very few times people give you guys gratitude and give these kids gratitude, and people need to do that. During these crazy times, these guys are sacrificing because they're not going to get these years back. And that's very important that these people make sure they appreciate it and don't bash these kids and make sure they give gratitude for what these people are doing as young men, young women, athletes in college, youth. Make sure you support these people, all right? So I know I'm on a little soapbox, but go Braves and Braves tough. We'll see you guys at Regionals. Thank you.